Today we will solve for mesh current using mesh analysis. Here we have four mesh, which are mesh I1, I2, I3, and then I4. An interesting part of this circuit is that we have this 5 amp share between mesh 1 and then mesh 2. And also we have this 3 I0 share between mesh 2 and mesh 3. Where the I naught is the I passing through this 2 ohm. So as we study in our last class, we know that when we have a current source sit between two mesh, then we should form a super mesh. In this case, mesh 1 and mesh 2 share the same current source 5 amp, and also mesh 2 and mesh 3 share 3 I naught dependent current source, so form this one also form super mesh. So mesh 1, 2 and 3 will form our super mesh. So now we have our super mesh and then mesh 4. Based on this, we have 4 unknown, I1, I2 and then I3 and then I4. So we need 4 equations to solve for it, and we will obtain the equation using KVL and KCL. So let's start with the super mesh. At the super mesh, then we apply KVL. Then start with this 2 ohm multiplied by I1. And then we walk along the loop, then we come up, we face 4 ohm, then 4 multiplied by I3, and this continue with 8 I3 minus 8 I4, because 8 ohm, we have the branch current is I3 minus I4, and then we walk back. And we face 6 ohm. This 6 ohm involved with I2, so we plus 6 I2, and we get back loop back to the original point. So this one summation is equal to 0. Then we simplify the equation. We obtain I1 plus 3 I2 plus 6 I3 minus 4 I4 equal to 0. This one is equation number 1. And then we apply KCL to obtain, since there are 3 mesh forming super mesh, so we will need 2 more KCL equation from this super mesh. So let's consider this position, the node P and then node Q. At node P, so we apply KCL at P. At node P, what we have is that you can see that the I1 fall into this direction, fall out of the node. And then I2 fall into node P, and we have this 5 amp fall out of the node. So we come up with the KCL equation. I2 is equal to I1 plus 5, and this is our second equation. And then we also apply KCL now at node Q. So at node Q, we will have this I3, right? So I3 in this direction, and then we have I2 going out of the node, and then we have 3 I0 fall into the node. So the equation will be I2 fall out is equal to summation of current that is getting into the node. So it equal to I3 plus 3 I0. Let's take a look at I0 here. So we can see that I not fall in this direction. So the direction is opposite with I fall. So I not is equal to minus I fall. So I not is equal to minus I fall. So this equation become I 3 I 2 is equal to I 3 minus 3 I 4. This is our third equation. Now we need more equation. So we still have mesh 4 here. So we apply KVL here. We will have 2 I 4 plus 10 and then plus 8 I 4 minus I 3. So we will have at mesh 4. We have 2 I 4 plus 10 plus 8 I 4 minus I 3 equal to 0. We combine this 8 and 2 and then divide equation by 2. Then we obtain minus 4 I 3 plus 5 I 4 equal to minus 5. So here we come up with question number 4. Now we have enough equation. We have 4 equation and 4 unknown. So we will try to solve for it. And so let's start. We can see that question number 2 is I 2 and question number 5 is also question number 3 is also I 2. So we compare this one, we obtain I 1 plus 5 equal to I 3 minus 3 I 4. So I 1 is equal to I 3 minus 3 I 4 minus 5. This one is equation 5. And then we substitute, we put 5, which is I 1, and I 2. So we put 5 and 3 into equation 1. Then we will have I 3 minus 3 I 4 minus 5 plus 3 I 3 minus 4 I 4 plus 6 I 3 minus 4 I 4 equal to 0. So we simplify this equation. We have 10 I 3 minus 6 I 4 equal to 5. And then I 3 is equal to 5 plus 16 I 4 divided by 10. And this one is question number 6. And then we put 6 into question number 4. We will have 5 I 4 equal to minus 5 plus 4 multiplied by 5 plus 16 I 4 divided by 10. So we will have 50 I 4 equal to minus 50 plus 20 plus 64 I 4. So I 4 is equal to 30 divided by 14, which is equal to 2.143 m. So after we have I 4, then we can get I 3 from form 6. So we form 6, we will have I 3 is equal to 5 plus 16 multiply to 143 divide by 10 and then we will have I3 is equal to 3.93 m. And since we know I3 and then I2 and then I3 and then I4, so we need to find I2. We utilize this equation 3. So from equation 3, we will have I2 is equal to I3 minus 3I4. Then we press the calculator, we obtain minus 2.5 m. And now we have to solve for I1. Then form 2, from equation 2, I1 equal to I2 minus 5. So we have minus 7.5 m. So our answer is this one for all mesh I1, I2, I3, and then I4. And here is this is the last example of our chapter 3. And so now we already study both of nodal analysis and mesh analysis, and you can utilize both, except that for non-planar network, for example 3D networks, then you need to apply nodal analysis only. Mesh analysis can utilize with the planar circuit only. And which one you choose? Actually, we will we would like to find a technique that form a fewer equation. So maybe you can count a number of nodes and a number of mesh in your circuit. If the number of nodes is less than number of mesh, then you better apply KCL. Mm-hmm. And also, it depending on which variable that the question asks you for. For example, if the question asks you for the mesh current, then maybe it's easier to apply the mesh analysis because you will come up with the solution right away. Mm-hmm. And also another thing is that to obtain fewer equation, then if you choose the ground node, the reference node, that at the node that connect a lot of element together, then that way you will come up with a fewer equation. Uh-huh. So that's all for this chapter.